In this article we are going to have our first look at the Daz Studio and how to use it. If you are a newbie and want to know all the basics, you are in the right place. After you have downloaded and installed Daz Studio, you should see something very similar to this. Check our other video if you want to learn how to install Daz Studio. Let's start by adding a character to the scene, a figure. To do so, we need to go to the Smart Content tab. This tab can be found on the left side of the interface, near the top. If you can't find it, you can always open any tab from the window, panes menu on top. In the Smart Content menu on the top there are Files and Products variants. This changes how you see the products that you own. You can use whatever, but we recommend Files. Then find the Figures section and there select any figure that you would want to have. I chose Genesis 8 male by double-clicking on it. We can see character appeared in the viewport. For the moment, character is fully naked. Let's fix that by giving them some clothes. To do that, you need to select a character. It should be selected by default, as you should see by the yellow outline in the scene tab. And by the white wireframe box around the character in the viewport. Filter by context option at the bottom left filters products by the selected object. So as we have character selected, we can only see products that will fit the Genesis 8 male figure. Proceed to the wardrobe section. Here you will see all the available clothing options for your character. Select any by double-clicking on them. You will see the clothes applied and fitted right for your figure. Besides being naked, the character is also bald. This cannot be a problem, but usually you would want to add hair. Do so by simply selecting any wanted hair from the hair menu. Same as we did with the clothes. Right now my person just floats in the air with nothing around him. So we need to add an environment to fix that. There are multiple ways of doing so, but let's stick with the simple and familiar one, using Smart Content tab. Remove the selection away from the character by clicking anywhere else in the Scene tab. More options has appeared in the Smart Content menu. Most importantly, Environments section. Here you will find all the environments that you have on your Daz Studio. We will use free pre-built shaded Haven environment. You can see that when you move mouse around your scene with environment, it flickers yellow. To fix this, just click on the arrow near the object in the Scene tab. This will make so that the object is not selectable in the viewport. So we added clothes, environment and hair. But the character just stands there with arms and legs out. We need to pose him to fix this. But there are nothing fitting in the Smart Content page. This is because the environment is selected and there are no poses for environment. Change selection to the character. The right products now appeared. Select the poses section. Here you can see all of the available poses. You can apply any of them by double-clicking. I like the standing seat pose. The character is posing, but its position does not make sense. To change the position we can use the translate tool. At the object's origin a gizmo will appear that you can drag around to move a figure. Alternatively, you can use parameters tab that is usually found on the right side. Here you can change the values directly. The character went out of frame. To move your viewport around, you should use view controls on the top right of the viewport window. Top button will orbit the view around. Next one allows you to pan your view. And the third one is to zoom in and out. Use acquired knowledge to change the view and position the character. The position is almost done, the character just needs to be rotated. There is a rotate tool available on top similar to the translate tool. or you can use the same parameters tab for this. Some finishing touches and the pose is ready. It is the time to finish the scene. The first important thing that we need to do is to add a camera. Just place your viewport in the way that you like. Use the aspect frame and thirds guide functions to help yourself. Adding camera is important because renders are done from the camera view. Add the camera by clicking on the Create a New Camera button. Important to change the option here to Copy Active View. This will make so that camera would appear at the place where your view is right now. Now you can change between the camera view and perspective view in the View Selection menu. This means that you can jump back to this position anytime you want. Before rendering, we also need to add lights. Same as we did with camera, change to perspective view and position it in the way where you want the light to be. Then press on the Create a New Spotlight and again select the Apply Active Viewport Transforms. After that, you can change to the spotlight view and adjust the placement. Make sure that it is pointing at the character. Now we need to change the light settings using the Lights tab from the right. Or find it at the window, panes as always. For some reason, the strength of the light, the luminous flux settings, is very low by default. It is set to 1500, which will do almost nothing in Daz Studio. We need to change it to hundreds of thousands. For example, 400,000 should work fine in this scene. Almost ready to produce the final render. All is left is change the render settings if you need to. Check our previous video to learn what settings there are and which do you need. For now, I will just change the max samples amount to something lower for faster render. And turn on the post denoiser to compensate for that a bit. After you are done with settings, just click on the render button on top. I am stopped, because as was mentioned before, renders are done from the camera view. But we are in the spotlight view instead. This is a common mistake, just change to the camera view from the view menu. And now finally press render and wait for it to finish. Here you can see the result render of our tutorial. Check out our site, renderguide.com, there you can find a lot more interesting information for beginners. Articles about lighting setups, HDRIs, cameras and a lot more. Or subscribe to this YouTube channel to learn all this from convenient videos that we will make. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration.